Welcome all of you students. Today, as part of the tenses, we are going to take the future continuous tense under the category of future tense. Look at this, our board. Here, it is written as future continuous tense. What is the incident or what is the situation in which context that the future continuous tense can be used is a major problem. Here it is, the actions will be in progress. This tense, the future continuous tense, can be used to express in connection with the actions which is in progress in the future. You understand this? So let us take some examples. So here the pattern of this tense is the subject. The subject plus will or shall plus B plus ing plus object. Here once again, the pattern of this tense is subject. There should be subject, then will or shall can be considered as auxiliary verb in the form of future continuous tense plus B plus ing plus object. You understand this? So here, let us go through the examples. The first example is, I shall be learning English. I shall be learning English at this time tomorrow. That is the incident which is to be taken place in the future, that is in progress. So I shall be learning, that is the progressive tense in the future. English, I shall be learning English, shall, here look at our pattern, here shall, that is shall or will, the B plus learning, verb plus ing, here verb plus ing, learn is the verb plus ing. So I shall be learning English at this time tomorrow. Here, look at the next example. Next example is, he will be sleeping. Here also, he is singular, and will is also here, be is also here, sleep is the verb, and ing, that is the progressive form, and when you go to see him. Look at the next example. Next example is, they will be waiting for us. Wait is the verb, along with this progressive form is waiting for us. Then, will you be coming with us? It's an interrogative sentence. So, the auxiliary verb will come first. So, we can say that, will you be coming with us? So, once again, we are going to study about the tenses, the future continuous tense and the category of tenses that is to be used for the action which is in progress in the future. Always remember that future continuous has two different forms, that is will be doing, it's one form, and be going to doing is the other form. Unlike simple future forms, future continuous forms are usually interchangeable. Remember that point. So, for example, you'll be waiting for her when her plane arrives tonight. That's a statement. So, each and every tense, the usage of each and every tense has positive sentences, negative sentences, and interrogative sentences. So, let us go through the examples. That is, will you be waiting for her when her plane arrives tonight? That's a question. Next one is, you will not be waiting for her when her plane arrives tonight. That's a negative sentence. So the form, remember about the form, that is future continuous with a be going to. Let us go through be going to. The simple future forms, that is future continuous terms, forms are always usually interchangeable. We can use two forms, that is be going to be doing, it is a part of this tense, and also will be doing. So let us go through the examples. that is you are, that is the form is am, is, are, plus going to be, plus present participle. So future continuous with the be going to can be stated like this, that is am, is, are, plus going to be, plus present participle. That is, you are going to be waiting for her when her plane arrives tonight. That is the statement. The second one is a question. That is, are you going to be waiting? Are you going to be waiting? Are you going to be waiting? Going to be doing like that. Are you going to be waiting? Like this. Are you going to be waiting for her when her plane arrives tonight? That's a question. Then next is a negative sentence, that is, you are not going to be waiting for her when her plane arrives tonight. Remember always, it is possible to use either will or be going to create the distance. Will or be going to. Will or be going to. Will or be going to. So either that can be used to create such tense of future continuous tense. Let us examine what are the uses of future continuous tense. That is, you say number one, that is interrupted action in the future. Let us go the interrupted actions in the future. That is when look at this diagram. Look at this diagram. And here is the past tense, the present tense, and future tense. So out of the present tense, this line, an incident is going to take place. The incident is going to take place, and that incident is interrupted. Look at this indu mark. It is interrupted. So like this, I'll be watching TV when she arrives tonight. I'll be watching TV. I will be watching TV. The interruption. What is the interruption here? When she arrives tonight. So when she arrives tonight, that is also the happening in which it is interrupted, and the sentence may become, I will be watching TV when she arrives tonight. Clear? So use the future continuous to indicate that a longer action, the future, will be interrupted. Use the future continuous to indicate that a longer action in the future will be interrupted by a shorter action in the future. Remember this. This can be a real interruption or just an interruption in time. For example, like this. I'll be watching TV when she arrives tonight. Like that. I'll be waiting for you when your bus arrives. Next example is, I am going to be staying at the Madison Hotel if anything happens and you need to contact me. The next example, we can say, he will be studying at the library tonight, so he will not see Jennifer when she arrives. Like that, always notice in the examples above and the interruption marked or symbol present. So here is when she arrives is symbol present. So always notice point. That is about that, the simple present rather than simple future. So actually it should be simple future, but we wrote it as the simple present. Simple present, always note that point. This is because the interruptions are in time clauses and we cannot use future tense in the time clauses. Once again, this is because the interruptions are in time clauses and we cannot use future tenses in time clauses. Then look at the use number two. This is the use number one, and this is the use number two. That is, the specific time as an interruption in the future. The specific time as an interruption in the future. That is the specific time. And here also, look at this diagram. This diagram, past, present, and future. Here, an incident is taken place here. The specific time, within the specific time, that is at 6 p.m. That is a specific time, Tonight at 6 p.m. I am going to be eating dinner. So you say number one is interrupted actions in the future. You say number two is specific time as an interruption in the future. Yes, look at the examples. You say number two. So tonight I will be in the process of eating dinner. I will be in the process of eating dinner. At midnight tonight, we will still be driving through a desert. That is, tonight at 6 p.m., that is a specific time. At 6 p.m., I am going to be eating dinner. Then look at the use of the will. I will be in the process of eating dinner. Then look at the next example. At midnight tonight, we will still be driving through the desert. Then look at the next one. We will be in the process of driving through the desert. So for our first example is, at midnight tonight, we will still be driving. Then by the usage of will, we will be in the process of driving through the desert. Both are the specific time. Here it is the use number two. These are the examples of which use number two, that is specific time as an interruption in the future by using will and be going to and going to be eating. Going to be eat plus ing. These are the examples. Like that, we will be in the process of driving through the desert. Remember, one point you have to remember, that is tonight at 6 p.m. I am going to eat dinner. Like that, I am going to start eating at 6 p.m. Tonight at 6 p.m., I am going to be eating dinner. Like that, I am going to start earlier and I will be in the process of eating dinner at 6 p.m. Then we can study USA number 3. Look at the USA number 3. USA number 3 is the parallel actions in the future. What is the parallel actions in the future? So here, in the present tense, both the actions are taking place in parallel at the same time in the future. So look at this definition, that is both actions will be happening at the same time. The actions are always parallel. Don't forget that. So when we use the future continuous with the two actions in the same sentence, it expresses the idea that both actions will be happening at the same time. The actions are parallel always. Example, I am going to be studying and he is going to be making dinner. Both these actions are taking place at the same time. One is I am going to be studying, that is one action. And he is going to be making dinner. That is the other action. That is, these are taking place at the same time. Tonight, we'll be making dinner. Tonight, they will be making dinner. Like that. So these two actions are taking place at the same time. The usage can be said to be the parallel actions in the future. Remember that no future in time clauses. In time clauses, there is no future. Like all future tenses, the future continuous cannot be used in clauses beginning with time expressions such as, this is very much important for the competitive, when you're going to write the competitive examinations, that is when, while, before, after, by the time, as soon as, if, unless, etc. I shall say once again, remember, no future tense in time process. That is, like all future tenses, the future continuous cannot be used in clauses beginning with time expressions such as when, while, before, after, by the time, as soon as, if, unless, etc. So instead of this future continuous, present continuous can be used. So instead of using this future continuous tense, in this context, we can use the present continuous tense. For example, while I am going to be finishing my homework, she is going to make dinner. So both are in the form of present continuous tense. It is not correct. This is not correct. While I am going to be finishing my homework, she is going to make dinner. It is not correct one. The correct sentence is, while I am finishing my homework, she is going to make dinner. And remember that, non-continuous, always remember about the non-continuous verbs in all of the six progressive tenses. What are the six progressive tenses? That is present continuous tense, present perfect continuous tense, past continuous tense, past perfect continuous tense, future continuous tense, and future perfect continuous tense. It is important. Now, what are the non-continuous verbs? It is important to remember that non-continuous verbs cannot be used in any continuous tenses. Instead of using future continuous, with these verbs, you must use simple future. Remember that. Example, Jane or Jani will be being at my house when you arrive. It is not correct. The correct form is, Jani will be at my house when you arrive. That is the correct form. Yeah. I shall say about what are the non-continuous verbs to be, don't use in all the continuous forms of the tenses. To be, to want, to cost, to seem, to need, to care, to contain, to owe, to exist. These are the abstract verbs. Then, to possess, to own, to belong. These are the possessive verb, possession verbs. To like, to love, to hate, to dislike, to fear, to envy, to mind, etc. These are the emotion verbs. Then, to smell, to taste, to think, to miss, to appear, to feel, to have, to hear, to look, to see, to weigh, etc. These verbs, these are the non-continuous verbs. These are strictly prohibited when you use all the six forms of the present or progressive tenses under the category of tenses.